Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today is another recipe video and I'm very excited. Like I was personally excited to, you know, make this recipe for quite a long time, make the shoot of this recipe for quite a long time because I personally love this thing which I'm going to show you right now. So this is spinach and this is a major ingredient for my recipe today. And today we are going to make green rice. So for me personally, I do not like spinach if it is made like a spinach curry or things like that. I like spinach in some different forms, and I know there are a lot of people out there who does that, but you know they avoid the spinach because they don't like the smell of it or they don't like the taste of it and things like that. And that was also like I was also in that genre, all the same. I mean, I don't like spinach personally, so that is when I improvised this recipe in which I can make a rice out of the spinach. It actually tastes really good. You mean you do not have that smell of the spinach in it, but you have all the benefits. Like spinach, as we all know, is very high in vitamin A, iron, and you know, it has a huge fiber content also. It's very good for health. So given all the benefits of it, it's very important to have spinach, include spinach in our daily routine. So that is when I came up with this recipe. So for this spinach recipe, I'm going to show you two recipes today with spinach alone. So for the first recipe, I'm going to show you a spinach rice and the next will be a spinach paratha. So for the first recipe, these are all the ingredients that I'll be requiring. The only thing which remains the same for the both recipe is spinach. So here I have just cut the spinach from the stems and then soaked them in the salt water just to, you know, get the extra dirt or whatever. I have washed it thoroughly though, but then after that also I have just soaked it in the salt water. Then I have taken rice here, and for this rice spinach recipe I require some garlic. So the garlic will be, you know, quite a large in number, because that is when it is, the smell of the garlic is going to hide the smell of the spinach, and that is how the taste is going to be. So the garlic here I had taken like around 6 to 7 cloves of garlic. I have chopped them, coarsely chopped them. It's some grated ginger, the chili. So chili is according to your taste. It is red chili powder. It is garam masala, turmeric, some sarso, that is mustard seeds, some cumin seeds, it is jeera, some peanuts and a little onion. So and tomato of course. So these are all coarsely chopped and all of it. So with all these things, I'm going to start with making the spinach rice recipe. The very first thing that I have to do is I start blanching with the spinach. So blanching is just like, you know, you just have to boil the spinach, just, you know, put the spinach in a boiling water with a little salt in it so that it becomes a little mushy. So let's just start doing it. So now I have taken a kadai in which I have put the water. So the water has to just start boiling, and then I am now adding some salt into it, and we'll be adding the spinach also. Just salt, you know, so that spinach absorbs the salt also. And then it has just become warm, and then now I'll be adding the spinach complete, like the whole bunch of spinach which I had, because though it looks like a lot of spinach, it gets when it is blanched and all, it becomes to a very less quantity. It comes to a very less quantity. So that is what I have to do it right now. I have to blanch it for like, you know, put it, that is a blanching means putting it in the boiling water for like around 2 to maximum 3 minutes. Now you see the water has just started boiling and the spinach also looks little, you know, soggy kind of a thing. And now what I'll do is that I'll immediately turn off the gas right now, and then I'll be draining out the water which is present here, and we'll be transferring the spinach into a mixer grinder and made a smooth fine paste of it. So that is the first step of the doing the spinach rice or even roti for that matter. The first step is blanching it and then making a fine paste of it. So let's just do the fine paste of it after draining out this water. Now I have just put the blanched spinach in this mixer grinder and have put one green chili also, and will be now blending it into a very fine paste. You see the paste is done. It looks so green, right? It looks so nice. So now what I'll do with this paste is that, you see, so much of quantity of spinach was there, but it has, when I have blanched it and make a paste, it is just like, you know, half a bowl. So now what I'll do is that I'll use half for the rice and I'll use half for the paratha recipe. So I'll take half of it and we'll start making the rice recipe. So let's begin with the rice recipe. For that I have taken the pressure cooker in which I'll be just putting some oil and will be warming it, and then let's see what to do next. So now I have taken the pressure cooker in which I have put like 2 spoons of oil, and now the oil that it is heated up, what I'll do is that I'll add the jeera and also the mustard seeds into it. Let them splutter for a while and then we'll be adding the other ingredients one by one. Now that my jeera and mustard seeds have stopped plus spluttering, I will be adding the garlic and also the ginger. Grated ginger and the coarsely chopped garlic. Here goes those. We'll just stir it for a while and then we'll be adding the onions to it. Now here I'll be now putting the onion and as well as the peanuts into it. This onion was like one medium sized onion. You can take 2 if it is small, or 1 if it is, one or half of it if it is big one. So here I'll add the onion and the peanuts together only. We'll just stir it for a while and then we'll be adding the masalas also one by one. You see, now my onions have become a little translucent. Now I'll be adding the turmeric, garam masala as well as the chili powder. Here goes the garam masala, chili powder, it's completely according to your taste, and also the turmeric. We'll add all of this and again we'll stir for a while and then we'll be adding the tomatoes. Now that my masalas also look cooked and it has become a little translucent and the masalas look nicely mixed with the onions and everything which was there, I am now adding the tomatoes, which was the second last ingredient, so as to say. So goes the tomatoes, and in this stage I'll be adding the salt also according to my taste. See, now the tomatoes also almost got cooked, so now I'll be adding the spinach here. Added the spinach just now, and then we'll be stirring the spinach with all the rest of the ingredients and the masala which is there in the pan. We'll wait for all the masalas and everything to get mixed for like maybe 2 minutes, and then we'll be adding the rice. So in the meanwhile, I have already soaked the rice in the water. So now before adding the rice, I'll just drain out the water with which it was soaked and we'll be adding the rice. Now you see that the masalas are completely cooked with the spinach, and also the smell which comes out from this vapor which is coming out from that, you can see that spinach wala smell is almost gone. In this stage I'll be adding the rice. So I have already drained out the water from my rice and I'll just add the rice completely to it. The rice is being added. I'll just stir the rice and mix completely with the ingredients present here, and then we'll be adding water to it. I have here taken 2 cups of rice. For that, just remember, do not add 1:2 proportion of water in this case, because the spinach already has a little bit of water content still remaining in it. So if you have taken 2 cups of here, I have taken 2 cups of water. So I'll be adding like 3.5 cups. I have taken 2 cups of rice. So for that, I'll be adding 3.5 cups of water only. Do not add more than that, then the rice becomes really soggy, so it won't even come out properly. So now I'll be mixing the rice with the ingredients which is remaining in the pressure cooker, and then we'll be adding 3.5 cups of water to it. Now you see the rice has started already sticking to the bottom of my pressure cooker. Now I'll be adding the water. So here for the 2 cups of rice, I'm adding 3.5 cups of water. Water is being added. Now I'll just add 1 spoon of ghee from the top and we'll be just closing the lid and waiting for 2 whistles, and then my rice will be done. So here goes this 1 spoon of ghee, and I'll just stir it with the complete thing which was there, and we'll close the lid and we'll wait for 2 whistles and then it is done. So that's how the rice is to be made. The green rice or the spinach rice has to be made. Stay tuned for more. I am also going to come up with in this video only about the green paratha or the spinach paratha. So that's all. Stay tuned. So yeah, my green rice or the spinach rice, however you call it, it is done. It is so fresh and green. It tastes equally good. And the best part is that you don't get the smell of the spinach, but you get all the benefits into it. So that's all. I'm going to have it with mango pickle. Stay tuned for the spinach paratha recipe as well. Bye. So now it's a turn to make the spinach paratha now. So what I have done is that this is the remaining spinach which was used for this rice. And so now with this remaining spinach, I'm going to make the paratha. So what I have taken is that I have taken wheat here. In the wheat, I have added some grated ginger, some garam masala, pinch of this chili powder. This is completely according to your level of spiciness. And here is this kalonji seeds. So in spite of kalonji seeds, if you don't like it or if you don't have have it, you can also use ajwain instead. So this is what I have taken. This is all that I'll be requiring for the spinach paratha. What I'll be doing is that I'll transfer this you know, boiled mixed spinach in this wheat. I'll be trying to make a pulp of it. We'll see how much the requirement of the water. Don't add water before adding the spinach, because then it might become very watery, and then you might have to add more and more wheat for that. So first add the spinach, see how much more quantity of the water is required just to make a plain dough of a paratha kind of a dough, and then keep on adding the water. So let me just do that now. Now that you see, I have started making the dough by mixing the spinach. I have here also added some salt according to the taste. So now I can understand that what is the quantity of the water that I'll be requiring for this. So now gradually I'll be adding the water and making a complete atta wala dough for the paratha. Now my dough making is complete. Now I'll start with making the round out of this paratha, and we'll make it in the paratha shape and just fry it like a normal paratha. So let's see how to do that also. Now you see that my paratha round is already done. I have put the tawa in the gas stove, and I'm just warming it up to put the thing in the tawa. So what we'll do is that initially I will just dry roast it, and then we'll be adding the water. So that makes it, you know, that requires less quantity of the water and also makes it really nice. Here I have started dry roasting the paratha. I'm just waiting for one side to get dry roasted, and we'll flip on the other side, similarly dry roast the other side, and then we'll be spreading like 1 spoon of oil. That will be sufficient. You can also use ghee instead of oil to make the paratha, and that is how it is to be done. So that is how simple and how easy it is, but it is a very nice way to eat spinach, for especially people who do not like the spinach, and more so for the kids. There are a lot of kids who are very fussy to eat spinach, and I remember I was one of them when I was a child. So that is how you need to make it, and yeah, that's all. I'll show you the paratha once it is done. Now you see my paratha is dry roasted already. See, you can see, can you see this fluffiness which is coming? So now here is the stage that I'll be adding now the oil or the ghee according to your preference. I am here adding white oil. So then we'll be making the paratha. Here I have just added oil on the one side, and just like few drops of oil on the other side I'll be just adding and making the paratha. Here you just spread the oil completely evenly on the paratha and then make it. And yeah, it is done. See, this nice green paratha. It looks so tempting, right? So it is now done. I'll just serve it now. So yeah, now the paratha is done. It looks so tempting and it tastes equally good. So yeah, please make it and try it out if you are especially a person who hates spinach like me. And even if you like spinach, it's a very good way, you know, to eat the spinach in this tasty way. So do let me know in the comment section below which one was your favorite, the rice, spinach rice recipe, that is a green rice recipe, or this green paratha recipe. So bye bye, take care, and till my next upload, please do subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed already, and also press the bell icon for notification of my subsequent uploads. Bye bye, take care.